Welcome to episode 2. I'm back at the National Cycling Centre.
Hello and welcome to episode 4.
This is episode 5. Tonight I'll be learning manualing and jumping.
Welcome to episode 6, where I'll be mastering the last of the BMX techniques, sprinting.
Welcome to the penultimate episode of BMX Zero to Hero. With only days left until the World Championships in Birmingham, I'm going to look back at my 9 months of being a BMXer and getting into my final preparation.
I'm feeling really excited to be competing in an event like the BMX World Championships. I've been ticking it off on my calendar for God knows how long. I'm going to see the track the day before I race, so I won't have that much time to practice on it, but I've learned how to take as much information in on a track as possible.
I'm very lucky to be here with pro BMXer Liam Phillips. With only a few days to go until the big race, this is a great opportunity to ask him some advice and information.
What advice could you give me for riding in front of the crowds at the Worlds?
For me, riding in front of a crowd means it makes no difference. Obviously, it's great to have the atmosphere and everything else, but it still doesn't change what you do on your bike. You still have to go from start to finish.
What advice could you give me to prepare the best that I can?
I think, you know, you have to see it as something that you're looking forward to and enjoyment. You know, if you see it as this big ordeal that you're going to have to go through, the chances of you performing to your capability is minimal.
Thanks to Liam for giving me some advice. It was really useful.
I'm just training as hard as I can, putting a bit more hours in, going to plat fields a little bit more, and just perfecting my skills and making sure that I'm not slacking at all, and that I arrive at the BMX Worlds at my peak. Every single session I go to now, there's somebody that comes up to me and says, "Are you that guy from the internet? Are you that BMX Zero to Hero guy?" And I'm like, yeah, I am. Yeah, that's me. There's been loads of support off Twitter, and it's really rewarding to see the help that I've been given to like little ones, because the videos are kind of set up as tutorials for them, and it is really rewarding to see on Twitter, my son's just won his first race night tonight, really proud of him, thanks for your advice. My family are really proud as well. My mum and dad take me to this BMX centre, about 20 minutes away, and take me about 4 times a week, and I really want to thank them a lot for the support they've given me. Well, I've always kind of defeatist attitude, because I'd never think I'd do well in a competition of this magnitude. But I'm just gonna do my best, and whatever happens, happens. The goal was to compete in the BMX World Championships, and as long as I give them a run for the money, just confidence in general. It's been really helpful, and it's a new hobby that I'm taking part in. It's just helped me to think that I can do something that I'd never think of doing before. Well, I'll definitely carry on my passion for BMX. It can't go away now. I'll still follow BMX, and it'll still keep a good place in my heart, because you can't really shake off an experience like this.
That's all for today. The next time you'll see me, I'll be on the start ramp in Birmingham, ready to race. Be sure to keep up to date with my final preparations and race the action by following me on Twitter. At BMX Zero to Hero, wish me luck.